Dear colleague, the study referred to the interference of nanotechnology and the proliferation of weapons of mass destruction. But what are the tangents of these two areas? At present time, the nanotechnology has demonstrated performance in top technology for 50s, 60s of the 20th century, such as nuclear, cosmic, and other fields. The crucial point for nanotechnology development took place in 2000 year with adoption by the United States of the National Nanotechnology Initiative, followed by the similar programs or strategy in the European Union member state, in the Russian Federation, China, etc. An important fact of approved National Nanotechnology Initiative is that it defines nanotechnology as a new state of manifestation of matter, with property very different from the same macrostructure. Nanotechnology are considered now one of the four pillars together with biotechnology, technology of new materials, and advanced digital production technology of the fourth industrial revolution. Unfortunately, like any cutting-edge technology, it can also lead to the development of new destructive technology, especially a weapon of mass destruction. Therefore, risk assessment of nanotechnology becomes critical in the context of dual-use technology. Analyzing the expected risk from the contribution of nanotechnology in various fields, we reiterate some of them. See you on slide 4. Thus, in the potential field, the consequence can be extremely varied because different entities with different cultural, political, religious security don't. The consequence on environment do not require much comment because the diversification of the uncontrolled discharge of particles the size of molecule or atom can lead to the serious consequences on biotic fauna, difficult to predict at present. If you refer to the consequences on human, on biotic in general, you must keep in mind that the toxicity of nanoparticles cannot be directly derived from the property of the some bulk material. Referring to security, the new generation of supercomputer, extensive monitoring of people based on nanosensors are obviously beneficial in the fight against terrorism. But this technology limits human rights and can also be used to suppress the mass action of people. Nanotechnology in the military sector, it is enough to analyze the perspective of the development of automated systems, robotic with auto-replication, which will cause an eventual confrontation of people with a new generation of artificial intelligence. From the above, it is obvious that nanotechnology today has the role of trigger in triggering the new way of existing a new opportunity. The challenge is so great that it's hard to imagine what awaits us on the horizon. In this context, you remember the god Janus, god of door, with the duality of the reality that awaits us when we pass through the door. The large-scale hostile use of nanotechnology is comparable to the benefits expected by society. If you analyze the perspective of the development of nanotechnology in various directions, you see that as practically at all stages of the manufacturing process, the results obtained can be useful in the development of weapons of mass destruction. You know the same in the analysis of the product development process already, which has different stages as biochemical system developed based on biochemical sensor, on biochemical energy sources, on biochemical membranes, viruses with certain property and destination. The availability of nanotechnology is already shown for the nuclear weapon of mass destruction, but it is becoming faster and more widespread than nuclear proliferation. When talking about the development of biological or chemical weapon of mass destruction, it is necessary to mention as example following. Nanoparticles are characterized as much more reactive compared to biological and chemical agents. Thanks to nanotechnology, the required quantities for the production and delivery of chemical and biological agents will be much smaller, so generating small production facility that are very difficult to detect by existing methods in present. The effect of the new materials at the nanoscale are much stronger because it increases the interaction area, which makes them more toxic and viral. The convergence of nanotechnology with chemical and biological technology create unique premises, such as for editing new molecule of bacteria, thus creating new species or new chemical with targeted properties. New methods of targeted delivery of nanotoxin make them virtually invisible to medical diagnostic and countermeasures. What are the threats coming from nanotechnology regarding development of weapon of mass destruction? Extension or dissemination of nanotechnology due to easy access to information sources through soft technology. Accessibility and acceptable price of nanotechnology attracting more and more states to develop their own weapon of mass destruction. The temptation of state actors to develop their own weapon of mass destruction, initially for defensive purposes, is to discourage potential aggressors. Nanotechnology makes these products substantially cheaper, as well as making them less visible, so they are easy to transport. Thus, they became more accessible to non-state actors who are less influenced by state or international non-proliferation regulation. It is now clear that nanotechnology are dual use, though some regulation are necessary and inevitable in the future. What is the research-medicine relation? You know that the medical research is intended to promote human health at the individual and population level through the set of ethical principles set out in the Helsinki Declaration. It is clear that in the field of health, inaction can cause the same harm action. On the other hand, research contributes to innovation in new medicine, vaccine, diagnostic and treatment, which are key components of public health intervention strategy. So, tightening the regulation of life sciences research may result in higher barrier and cost for research on pathogens. The promotion of dual-use products also increases the possibility of malicious use by providing informational material that will help state or non-state malicious actor to develop agents for a biological attack. On the other hand, the modification of or creation of pathogen requires the implementation of responsibility not only for biosafety, but also for biosecurity. The relation chain continues after the dissemination or publication of information, being impossible to limit access to information. For these reasons, discussion on the risks and benefits of dual use start later. Ideally, discussion on dual use risk should take place before, not after the research. So it is difficult to predict the usefulness of new technology for malicious application. Let's analyze some threats that came from the application of nanotechnology in medicine. Medical implant. Medical implant and other digital medical devices can become targets of misuse. The signs of this trend are already noticeable. So in August 2017, the United States Food and Drug Administration issued a safety statement on the potential cybersecurity vulnerabilities of several pacemakers. This vulnerability included the risk of intentional using the device to discharge its battery or to introduce malicious programming commands into the device. Because the device at risk has been implanted on about 500,000 patients, cybersecurity concerns are not only due to the severity of the case, but also to the possible magnitude. Similar vulnerabilities have been identified in drug infusion pump brain implant, such as deep brain stimulation, non-invasive brain-computer interface. Other example, neurobiology is warning the possible use of neurotechnology for military purposes, aggression or defense, in international and domestic conflict. For these reasons, the three main areas in which ethical questions arise have been identified as the use of neural devices in interrogation, the involvement of military personnel in the research process, and the neurotechnology developed for therapeutic application but used for military purposes. But what is the role of the researcher that engineer in the field of research and innovation in non-proliferation with nanotechnology and nanoengineering? Researchers are the most knowledgeable and best placed professionals to assess the nature and seriousness of the potential for misuse of knowledge, products, or technology. So, they should be responsible for evaluating and reporting this finding to the research institution or national regulatory bodies. But this goal is rarely put in the front of them by the condition of funding research projects. Research has been and is vulnerable to abusive, unethical application or research result because they generate and provide knowledge, materials, methods, and technology, including in the form of CBRN products. They could be channeled into crime or terrorism. They lead to the general free dissemination of information or useful exchange of information, but also guided by the support of human right to information access. They does not ensure the awareness of future research in terms of innovation that could represent dual use. Even if free a database or scientific result and innovation, their vulnerability is not critically assessed and security measures are exceeded for various reasons. What are the recommendations for minimizing or combating the unwanted proliferation of research innovation results? Conducting self-assessment of research risk during or before research, including by updating regularly the assessment model for high-risk areas. Adjusting safety and security measures to counteract safety risk at any stage of research. Assurance of educational through the elaboration curriculum and introducing at the bachelor's or master's degree discipline on interference of non-proliferation of weapons of mass destruction and nanotechnology and nanoengineering. And let's not underestimate the growing role of information and cybersecurity in non-proliferation in all fields and domains. Thank you for your attention. Any questions, if there are?
Thank you, Mr. Buzdogan, for your very interesting presentation and look on the nanotechnologies from another angle, from another corner. It's a very important item, I see. And questions, please.
No questions. Thank you again for your attention.
I have one question, please.
Yeah, please.
How you see, Professor Artur, are required to organize some state such of agencies which will giving some like of the permissions for producing of nanotechnology research and also industry companies which are preparing nanotechnology materials.
Yeah, I think in the future, of course,
like of the regulations related to the radioactive researches.
Yes.
In radioactive field.
At present time, there are no such agency as regulatory body, for example, as you said, the nuclear radiological field. But in the future, I don't know, maybe in 10, 20 years, the necessary to organize such agency will be at the table, obligatory, because you know that the perspective of nanotechnology is unimaginable, and the positive and negative action from the utilize the potential of technology, of database, for example, or different elaborated methods and sensor, for example, will be necessary to regulate through the special law and through the special permission from the regulatory agency in such subject, for example. But in the future, not now, it is too early to discuss because many people don't understand the possibility of contribution of nanotechnology and nanoengineering and proliferation of different type of weapon of mass destruction.
Thank you very much. After 20 years without us. Yes.
Maybe.